Today we're going to talk about temperature intolerance. I'm Dr. Carrie Lam. This is Dr. Michael Lam. Please define for us what temperature intolerance is.
Well, our body has a automatically built-in mechanism where it regulates the internal core temperature, which is maintained to be about 98.6. So if we are in an outdoor environment where it's hot, the sweat glands expand and we sweat to reduce the body temperature down. And similarly, the opposite occurs when you're in a cold temperature. In adrenal fatigue, I think because of the bioenergetic circuit, which is one of the six circuits that regulate our body's stress response, can become imbalanced or dysregulated. And when this happens, the body just doesn't do well, especially in a hot temperature. And hot temperature can mean going outside in the direct sunlight for a few minutes, could be going to a sauna or a steam room that is hot, could be taking a hot shower. And the consequence is that the body just feels drained because it just does not know how to deal with the temperature dysregulation within. So therefore, the body puts out more cortisol, puts out more adrenal function in order to reduce the inflammation and the physiological construct that goes along with it. So a person typically would then tell you, oh, I'm just so fatigued, I'm so tired, I get dizzy, you know, I feel nervous, you know, I have heart palpitations when I take a hot shower. Even a hot bath can be a problematic. These people usually do better in a temperature, maybe 68, 69 degrees Fahrenheit. They tend to do better, the body tend to do better in a colder environment versus a hotter environment.
Mm-hmm. So the thermal regulation is a little off.
Yeah, and the thermal regulation has to do with many factors. It can be the baroreceptors, can be the vasomotor receptors. We're not quite sure exactly what it is, but obviously there's some imbalance, and we see this quite often. The good news is that this is a symptom that can be reversed. Oftentimes, if your body re-establish itself, because it's really a symptom, it's not a disease. It's not that you have a sympathetic problem, which does happen in some people. They just actually have a sympathetic nervous system problem that leads them to sweat profusely. That is a form of dysautonomia, but that's not what we're talking about here. We're talking about just not feeling well when they're taking a hot bath. They cannot tolerate going out into the sun for, you know, 10, 15 minutes in direct sunlight. They feel better when they're in the shade. Mm-hmm. That type of kind of a discomfort, you see.
And mm-hmm. You've gone through this. That's why you understand.
Well, yes. And believe me, it's not something you think about until you actually experience it yourself and say, wow, you know, why am I so intolerant of this heat? It appears everybody has no problem. I have the problem. So, you know, this is when, in my own journey, I started to investigate and do research and try to figure out what is wrong with this whole temperature regulation. And it is a very important part of the bioenergetic circuit. It's one of the six key circuits that regulate our neuroendometabolic response. And that's why, you know, without this understanding, most people just keep crashing themselves and don't even know why.
And this circuit also has the thyroid organ part of it.
Yeah, and the thyroid is one of the key mechanism regulations regulating the body temperature for sure. The basal body temperature is regulated by the thyroid. And you can have a perfect thyroid, and you still can have these unpleasant symptoms if your adrenals are not working well.
Mm. So you talked mostly about heat intolerance, people who can't really handle the heat. Does it happen with a cold too?
A cold is less, for reasons we don't quite understand. But most people tend to do better. If it's between hot and cold, you want to be on the cold side, mm-hmm. see? And you feel more comfortable overall.
Okay, so that's our video about heat intolerance. Whether you're having it or not, we would like to hear from you. So make sure you comment down below what temperature is your favorite temperature to be at. Like our video and make sure to share it. We're here to empower you to take control of your health. Hope you enjoyed this video.